Beware of wolves in sheep's clothing, girlfriends.
Beware, girls.
They will tell you that you're not good enough in a very indirect way.
They always do.
That is how it all begins. Indirectly.
Everything is indirect nowadays.
They will belittle your small successes with even bigger downfalls.
Why is that?
They will never be happy for you. They will come one by one like sin crouching at your doorstep asking you what it is that you really want, but never quite giving it to you.
I've never had it.
They will whisper shallow thoughts into your soul, create desires in you that are questionable by inciting false hopes of a reality that you will never ever know, no matter how long you wait for it. Behind your back, in front of your face, they will mock you for your intensity to be loved.
I am intense.
They will appear to want what you want, to seek what you seek. But they will never love you unconditionally.
Only God does that.
Because their rendition of love always comes with conditions. And that condition is lust.
Why is it always lust?
So don't you fall for it. Don't you fall for it at all.
Sadly, I have.
When you are with them, they will hinder your progress, undermine your independence, downplay your intelligence by calling everything you say, think, and do cute sexiness. As they attempt to lure you away from God.
I'm sorry, God.
But don't you let them do it, for you will regret it and lose everything that makes you you in the first place. When you are alone, they will tell you all the things you long to hear, all the things you never heard much of when you were a girl. Like, I love you, you are so beautiful, girl.
And you believe them too.
Then they will wrap you up in lust and ship you off to never, never, I will never marry you land, because I'm secretly waiting for a good girl that I can respect.
So many guys do that.
That is something that they will not tell you directly, but something that you will learn eventually, after many, many years of heartache and pain. After you notice a continuous cycle in your life happening over and over again, that is when you'll start to recognize the demons in your life. Pretending to believe in you, pretending to care, pretending to grasp your spirituality by reciting a few lines from the Bible as if it were their own personal diary, all the while claiming to see the God in you, but not inside of the church, because there are soulless creatures walking around in empty shells, waiting for the moment that you compromise your standards, bend on your beliefs and let them into your heart and eventually into your bed. So guard your heart diligently. Keep your eyes wide open to the truth, and in precious time, they will reveal themselves eventually.
Some are clever.
Then you will know just what to do. Slam the door to your heart shut immediately, and never open it up for them again. Because real men,
where are they?
Real men come courting in the daytime and not at 3 a.m. with a true offer of friendship and a real commitment built on trust, bearing their hearts and souls to you with God's true intentions for you and not their own sexual agendas.
They always have agendas.
Trying their best to undermine God's ordained plan for you by messing up your life. Trust me when I say to you, girlfriends, make sure you look out for those wolves in sheep's clothing. There are so many of them these days.